Hi guys, it's me Joy, and today I will be sharing with you my completed December daily. Woohoo! So if you don't know about December daily, check out AliEdwards.com. She's the one who created this project, and it's a mini album project that documents the 25 days leading up to Christmas. And according to her, the simple goal is to capture the spirit of December one story per day. So I started my project on Thanksgiving. So mine goes from Thanksgiving until December 31st. And here it is. I don't know if you follow me on Instagram, but it looked completely different in the beginning of this project. I just tied it with a little twine just because I thought that this was a very festive kind of string, and my December daily is so fat that I think it needs it. So I used a regular TN insert. This is the old craft insert. You can tell because of the white spine. Before I started the project, I already had this sticker on here. So I was trying to figure out, what am I gonna do with this sticker to make it look more Christmassy? So what I did was made it into a snow globe, because I think snow globes are pretty holiday-ish. And I took this bear from a really old collection, actually, from Pink Fresh, and cut him out to look like he's peeking, and then I added these words. Then I stamped out, "Merry Christmas, you filthy animal!"
Christmas, you filthy animal! And a Happy New Year!
Later on during the month, I put this gold star. I think I got it from the sticky kit, if I'm not mistaken. And then my friend Mia, when she gave us gifts, she put this like wax seal. And it's kind of like a Mizuhiki string thing. She attached this tag that says Merry Christmas. And then I attached this Starbucks gift card that looks like an ornament on there. I just tied it on with her tag. Let's get into it. Here I just covered this side with some buffalo plaid paper with, I think this is Simple Stories, this cutout thing. Then here I just put a sticker of a panda and a polar bear, and it says Holiday Adventures of Lucky and Bucket, which is my husband and I, and just some other stickers. I just kept it super simple. Here I have a picture of Elf, Buddy the Elf, Will Ferrell. Ali Edwards tells you to say what your intentions for this project are. So I got this off of Pinterest and I just typed it on my typewriter. And I typed it on this paper that I got from the stationery selection subscription. And it's just this really pretty white paper. And if you could feel it, it would be even better, because this side is very smooth. And then the other side has like a nice texture on it. And you could see like the designs, which is so pretty. And at the beginning of the project, I stamped this Daruma stamp. It looks like this. It's from Baumkuchen. And what you do is you stamp it and you fill in the eye when you make your intention. This purchase was completely inspired by Write Your Life. I'll link her channel down below. Oh my gosh! This is so cool. I filled in one eye at the beginning of the project, and then when I finished it, I filled in the other eye because it's now complete. Then on this side, I just wrote my real reasons of why I decided to do this project, and this is my fourth attempt at this December daily. Maybe later this year, I will do a video of my failed attempts at December daily. And I just put this post-it here, and it's of a polar bear, and I just typed out intentions and a winter bucket kind list. And I got this from, I believe, Cute Things from Japan. So this next spread is about Thanksgiving, and I just wrote about what happened during Thanksgiving. And here's a picture of my family, well, some of us. And the funny story behind this picture is that we were taking a boomerang, and a lot of my older family members, they're not really familiar with boomerangs, so they just stood still. And I think my dad was one of them, and my uncle was one of them. So when you watch the boomerang, they're just like scarily still, which is super hilarious. I use this paper that I from a forget who the artist is. Aiko Fukawa. I got this from the stationery selection. It's a box. I forget which box it was. I think it was November. I don't know. Check Mitz's channel, My Life Mitz. I'll link her down below as well. I used that And I really wanted to use this paper because it looks like they're having Thanksgiving. And on the other side, I added more pictures. And this is my dad and my auntie. And my auntie's like showing my dad like how the boomerang looks and stuff. And me and my cousin. And on this side, I just wrote what I was thankful for. This was about Black Friday. After Thanksgiving, I went with my cousins to Best Buy. And it was crazy with bajillion TVs everywhere. But this is my cousin's first time to witness the magic of Black Friday. I drew this camera and it says, "Oh yes, you will be mine.
It will be mine. Oh yes, it will be mine."
Because she really wanted this camera that they were having on special. It's the Sony 5100, I think. Or was it the A6000 she wanted? I don't remember. But it was one of the mirrorless Sony cameras. I just journaled some more about what we did. Then this was on the 25th, and it was really rainy that day. And I started playing, well, I didn't start playing. I continued to play Animal Crossing Pocket Camp. And that day it was really, really rainy and gloomy. Here I wrote about going to the supermarket and I got a breakfast bento, and I drew here the anatomy of a breakfast bento. Just drew some fried rice and scrambled eggs, Portuguese sausage. We technically only went there for potatoes, sorry, I was pointing to the onions. But we technically only went there to buy potatoes. Then here I actually filmed a video. I forget which video I filmed here, but I didn't like it, so I scrapped it. And here's a picture of potatoes. Next, I tried this overnight oats in the toasted coconut and almond crunch flavor. And if you see here, there's a tab that I made out of sticker paper and it says look with the pointy finger. And I wrote my review of it and it was womp womp. So I put rating 1 star. I also did some like destashing of washi and stamps. So I drew Marie Kondo. And I said, Con Marie would be proud. On this side, here's a picture of my husband's office area. And it's just of, you know, those lights that you project onto the building. Thought it was very holiday-ish. And more from that paper pack by Aiko Fukawa from Stationery Selection. This side, I just documented how I was making Christmas cards. Here was my first red cup of the season. Red cup. It's not completely red anymore, but... And me and my husband went to his future school because he's going back to school. And I just cut out the pastry bag paper. Is that what it's called? Oh, and later on when I had a meetup with one of my crafty friends, Steph, who is Sweet Aloha Girl on Instagram, she let me have some of her Starbucks tape. And then later on, when I saw Mia, my decorated mess, she let me have her Japanese Starbucks tape. And I really love this card. It's like a message card and it has a bear and a coffee kind of theme. And I just wrote what we had for our first red cups of the season. This stag head is from Steph again, Sweet Aloha Girl. I had my hair done at Finca Hair Salon and I just had it Japanese straightening kind of treatment. And I drew a picture of my hairstylist, Yumi. I have my Dear Santa page. This is Don's Dear Santa. I don't know if he was being serious though, because he said he wanted spearfishing gear and he's never shown interest in spearfishing. I have just some non-materialistic things and some private things that I covered up. This paper is from Celebrations, this store in Hawaii that sells some Japanese stationery and also gift wrapping items. And I thought this was very, very cute. On this page, I have a piece of our Christmas card here because that's what I was doing all morning, was doing our Christmas cards and watching Harry Potter. And then on this side, it's a picture of this restaurant that is opening soon because a lot of restaurants around here closed and now like all these new ones are popping up, so that one is coming soon. Then this day is about Live Life and Create Florence. She had like a planner crop or crafty Frosty Girl Crop, or I forget what the exact name of her event was, but we had that at Ala Moana, and here are some pictures I have. And this doggy was there. His name is Duran, and he's a service dog, and he was so cute. He was like a giant bear. And when you flip, I just have the description of these pictures on the back. And I have my raffle name that I won a sticker book. And here's me and my friend Steph. I drew some coffee and egg McMuffin-y kind of sandwich. Then I wrote about Red Nose Day, actually, because I was watching Love Actually, and I was thinking about how this character, Laura Linney, her character, she didn't get a happy ending, but everybody else did. So I was like, I wonder why they did that. So I was like looking up theories, what others' theories were about her character. And then I found this Red Nose Day, actually, and I thought it was super funny. I'll link it down below. My favorite scene in there was of Andrew Lincoln from The Walking Dead. I went to Lush and I got my yearly tradition, which is Snow Fairy. I didn't know that scent puts me in that holiday season, so I got that. And I just cut this out of the bag because I really like this green color, and I stuck my receipt in there. And on this side I have our Christmas card. It sticks out, but that's fine. I put this tab where you can pull it out. I also have my mother-in-law's card because she painted this for us. She is part Native American, so that was pretty cool. She painted the teepee. And here is our card. I made this wraparound return address label. I drew this picture. Ta-da! It's a snowflake. I'll talk about this more in a later page. But I just wrote a letter to ourselves inside for next year when I look through this again. And then I just backed it with this sticky kit because I really like their backgrounds. And I wanted to see through the vellum of their cute backgrounds of their envelopes. And this one, I wasn't sure what I was doing with these pages. I was just experimenting. Here, I just put some movies I was watching. I always start the holiday movie watching season with Harry Potter. Here, I got this card from Christina, who is my crafty friend here in Hawaii. And she gave everybody succulents at the Live Life and Create event. And I kept the card. I used it to frame Mochi Cat's face. And you can see him through the Christmas tree. And if you flip it, I wrote all his Christmas list, his Dear Santa list. And on this side, we had some sandwiches from our market, and Don got me a donut and chocolate milk. And here is Mochi again under the tree, and this snow fairy from the Lush catalog that I cut out. This Pando Commando that says there is this mascot. Is it a mascot? I don't know what to say, call them. I guess mascot. It's like my husband's old unit was 10th Mountain, and they have the 10th Mountain Pando Commandos, and the Army versus the Navy football game, they had the Pando Commandos on their uniform, and they won, so I was like, pandas are lucky. One of my old favorite shows, Psych, came out with a movie. I just wrote a quote here that he always says, and it's, I've heard it both ways. Then we had pizza. And I just stuck in the brochure, and I used this classic-y receipt paper to say what we had. Then I just put from Sticky Kit, and I had a muck rib. Because they come out with this once a year, and every year I have one. And it's like when I order a pumpkin spice latte, I want to order one, and then I'm like, eh. And then so it's the same way with McRibs. I order it once, and I'm like, eh, that's that. And I just added some stamps from the sticky kit. Here is my process of how I came up with this Christmas card. So I was doing this challenge for myself in October, where I was looking through my old pictures and drawing them. I got that idea from Char Villena, and I'll link her channel down below. Anyway, while I was looking through my pictures, I found this old snowflake I cut out of the Stormtroopers, and it's by Anthony Herrera, and I thought that would be a cool idea for a Christmas card, so I traced it on the silhouette, and I cut it out with the silhouette with white sticker paper, and bada boom, bada boom. The rest is history. I kind of drew out what I wanted the inside to look like, but it ended up not looking like that. It ended up looking more like this, which is even cuter in my opinion. Our sentiment inside was very Yoda-ish, and I said, "Merry and bright may your Christmas be." My hairstylist doesn't cut my hair after I get it straightened. She prefers for it to marinate. Is that the right word? So I got my hair cut and I got a lob, which is a long bob. And I put lob life. That is before and after. I tried my best to look sad in my before picture. This one is one of my favorite spreads. This is from my friend Steph with her gift that she gave us when I went for a meetup with them. And then this is from my friend Mia. And she has very pretty handwriting and it reminds me of the Daily Roll. She gave me this thing. This shiny side you should use for like writing. And then this backside is more padded and it's great for stamping. And she's right. I tried it a bunch of times already. It does make your stamp look more even. There's that. And then this is from a card that Mia gave. And then I took a picture of that washi tape I used. So I just wrote about us and then I wrote more and I cut out a lot of brochures that we took, which was a funny joke because everywhere we went, we like, do they have a free brochure? We took it all for our books. And then here's a spread of pictures of us, but I covered everybody's faces to protect their identities, just in case they don't want to be shown on camera. So I just did that for them. And on this page, I took a picture of my breakfast or brunch, and it was the French toast. I took a picture of Mia's coffee, which had coffee ice cubes, which was cool, and creamer, which was in a little like mason jar. It reminded me of this drink in California that they served coffee ice cubes with Mexican Coke. I forget what it was called, but I know that used to be a thing in LA. And then when you flip it down, it's the menu and what everybody ate. And when you flip this out, this is part of the brochure we took and the outside of the restaurant and my rating. I gave it only 4 stars just because they didn't have brochures for us to take. In the background, you can see the map of South Shore Market. On this side, my cousin, I don't know if she could consider her my cousin. I'll just call her my cousin. She needed a couch, so I gave her one of our old couches that we were not using. And she took a picture of it in her new space and said it looks perfect. And here I use another one of the Aiko Fukawa. I don't know if I'm saying it right because I don't remember, but I took more of those papers. I went to my cousin's house to help her film this video for her channel, and I'll link her channel down below if you want to watch what we made. She had such an eventful year, like a crazy eventful year, that she wanted to make a video about it. I went to her house all day to help her film that, and it was really fun. Here are my best 9 of 2017. I only posted 40 things on Instagram in 2017, which is really pathetic, and I'm trying to up my game on Instagram. And here are my favorite Vlogmas people. One of my extremely favorite was Christopher Allen and Christina Brawley, Char Dulac, Cindy Llama Loves Lettering. She makes me laugh. So I watched those guys. Here I wrote about this origami box that I made. I don't know if you watch Rainbowholic, but she uses this origami box for her trash. So I made some for myself. So here's the one I made first, and it's out of scrapbooking paper. And I put a bowl on it. It's just very convenient if you're on the couch and you don't have a trash can next to you. You can just put this next to you and just put trash in it. Thank you, Rainbowholic. Here I was texting with my aunt and my cousin's best friend about her upcoming baby shower. We were like planning things. She has requests of what she wants her baby shower to be like. And I thought it was funny what her best friend said. He was like, she's so extra. I don't know, it just made me laugh. And this one, I went to the eye doctor and Starbucks. Steph had this brochure from Starbucks. I saw it there. I was like, ooh, free brochure. So I got one and I really like this gnome. I actually saw this gnome on clearance, but I was like, what am I gonna do with a gnome on my desk? I didn't get it, but now I kind of want it. But no, don't need it. Then you saw this in my previous video, which was my holiday playlist. On this side, I didn't do that much that day, so I just wrote, today I watched too much Hallmark Channel. Boy, with the poodles already. But at least I did laundry. I used to work at 20th Century Fox, and I found out that they got bought out by Disney, and this is an old Simpsons cartoon where it says 20th Century Fox, and it says a division of Walt Disney Company. Here I drew Tom Haverford and Donna Meagle from Parks and Rec, because that's where the treat yourself is from.
Three words for you, treat yourself.
Treat yourself 2011.
Treat yourself.
It's the best day of the year.
The best day of the year.
And I just put like all the treats that I had. This is from Linda, I think. And it has like the Reese's Pieces she gave. And I always eat the white peppermint M&Ms. This one is the white fudge covered Oreo. And I have a very specific memory of my dad going to work really early in the morning during Christmas break. We'd wake up at the same time and he'd be getting ready for work. And I'd be eating Oreos and watching Home Alone. So I just wanted to write that down. Just better write all the memories that come to my mind. We went to watch The Last Jedi. I've added this Mochi Crunch wrapper from the theater because this Mochi Crunch wrapper has not changed since I was a kid, which I found amazing. This Rila Kuma bag is from Steph, and I put our tickets in there. And I took a picture of my popcorn and Mochi Crunch. I have a coupon for a free combo, and I didn't like came with a candy. And I got Raisinets, and Don made fun of me. He's like, Raisinets? That's weird. When I went on that crafty date with Steph, Linda, and Mia, we saw this artist at Mori. What he does is he takes Star Wars characters and puts them in like vintage Hawaii poster kind of things, and I thought that was pretty cool. And their exhibit says, "May the aloha be with you." And then I wrote a quote from Maz. And here is another Star Wars, like an extra snowflake sticker that I had. And I documented my Christmas mug, which is like a Star Wars ugly sweater. What day was this? The 16th, yeah. I was halfway there, pretty much. And this is where it gets really minimalist. So I wanted to try a different way of writing my caps. I really admire the Daily Roll, and there's another girl that I like her handwriting, but another girl, I don't remember her name, and then Mia, and they have this like italicized, skinny, tiny font, and I was like, I want to try their font. So for the rest of the book, that's the font I use. It's fun to experiment with different handwriting. Here's the dinner I had that day. Here's my box of Christmas movies and books. Here I went to Target with my mom and brother, and free brochure again. So I just cut out this Letters to Santa mailbox because I just like the look of it. I kept everybody's stamp because I really like the stamps, and it says where it's from, so I thought that was cool. Here's Don, and he just looks cozy. Since he looks so cozy in his pajamas, I decided to document what kind of pajamas I'm wearing for this holiday season, and I'm wearing like a cat pajama and this plaid, pink and gray plaid pajama. Or actually, these are thermals from Victoria's Secret, and this one's new. This one's from my aunt last year. Those are the pajamas I was wearing. This one I had a funny conversation with Don, and then this picture of Mochi was funny because he looked like Superman. And then I wrote a quote from Parks and Rec. You had me at meat tornado. I don't know, that made me laugh, so I recorded that. I had this hot cocoa mix, and I cut the bear out, and I made him look like he was holding the Starbucks gift card. And inside is one of the cards from this year, which is the gingerbread. That's super cute. I love it. Here we went to get pizza, and it just looked so good that day, so I decided to take a picture of it. And I wrote here on this side, a lovely cheese pizza just for me. Where is that from?
A lovely cheese pizza just for me.
This is a cat at Don's working place, and he looks like this other cat that roams around our property, and his name is Poke, which is after the food, and we called him Poke of the North because he looks like Poke, but he's more fuzzy, like he has a winter coat on. So we called him Poke of the North, but then later on we changed it again to Poke of Winterfell. Here's when I got my December kit from Sticky Club. So this is from Sticky Club. It was called Vintage Print Shop. And this is also from that. And that day I baked cookies. And we went to PetSmart or Petco, I don't remember. I think PetSmart. They had this new collection. It says here, apparel for dogs, but it's a kitty sweater. So it's like cultural appropriation. And I really like this washi tape. It's polar bears and this one says, lovely to see you. This side I already showed in my previous video, but I'll show it again. Here are the three wrapping papers and the ribbons, which the buffalo plaid was inspired by Steph, because she was like, there's lots of buffalo plaid ribbons at Walmart. Then here are my favorite ornaments this year, which is the snowman and this bear. Here's my nativity scene. It's really tiny. This happened in November, but I decided to put it here when me and my mom went Christmas decor shopping. This is just from stuff that we bought. Here is our Christmas card circle and our Christmas tree. Christmas Eve was kind of sad because Don was working and I didn't want him to be alone before he went to work. So I didn't go with my family to the family party because I wanted to spend it with him. I just put this picture of what people in Japan do. I think this is from, I forget what her name is on Instagram, but she posted this really cute graphic of how they eat KFC chicken and Christmas cake. And here's Mochi Cat, and he has his favorite treat now, which is milk. Here are some things that we got for Christmas. We got a cat ornament from my auntie and some other things here, like gift cards and cash, drinkware. As you can see, I got like lazier and lazier to do this. Here's some packaging from things I received, like this new pen that I got from the stationery selection, which is a pretty good pen. It's the preppy fountain pen. It's really smooth. This is Don's favorite candy this holiday season. It's the Hershey's Peppermint Bark Bells. And then on this side is a very private conversation that I covered up. Here's the stationery selection. I think this is the day we got it. So there's that. Then on this day we went to Costco because we were hosting New Year's Eve at our house, so me and my mom went shopping for stuff for the party. Here I was brainstorming my one little word, and here's the word I chose this year, which is gumption. And if you flip it, it says what the dictionary meaning that I'm taking it as, which is courage, spunk, and guts. Why I chose it is because I don't feel brave enough to share a lot of my creative endeavors, so I feel like I need gumption. So that's why I chose that word. Here were some other words that I was thinking about, but that's my word this year, is to be more brave with sharing with you guys. Because sometimes I watch my stuff back and I'm like, so then I scrap it. Then just more random things that I had. The hot cocoa Oreos. This is from a gift card from one of my aunts. I went on like a giant errands kind of trip with my mom and my brother. And here's my brother wearing those funny looking blazers at Target. And then on this side is when I was doing my planner setup. So when I flip it out, it's just like what I'm gonna be using things for. Here I went to run errands with my husband this time, and we ate Korean barbecue, and he got a haircut, which is why I have this scissor. And I really like this sticker from Mitts that she gave. It's like a sticker flake, and it says, start your day with a smile. And then, oh, this one is making me sad. So I have this hand lotion from Japan, the Cool Honey, and I ran out, and I love this hand lotion so much that I like seriously cut the top and like scooped out that lotion because some good stuff, man. And it's the last day of the year, which is New Year's Eve, and here's my family. And we had such a great time. I went all out. We have a fire pit, so I made s'more packs, and this is a sticker I put on each pack. And I made custom cups, and I made this bear that says a cup of cheer. And we watched one holiday movie, we played games, and it was fun. I even made a popcorn bar and a hot cocoa bar. But we had so much fun that night, and it was a great memory. And if you want to watch some stuff that we did, you can look on my Instagram because I saved that story on there. Here I wrote the reflections for this project and tips for next year. Oh, this is from the bag that I made for the popcorn. It says, treat yourself. And here's some of my resolutions or goals. And things to look forward to for 2018. And Mochi Cat is finished with 2017, so I put that picture in. This is a gift card holder that I had, and that's it. So that was my December daily project. I hope you enjoyed. I apologize if it was really long. See you next year, December daily. Bye, guys.